No, it's not. It's not another dance video. Don't worry. What's up? What's up, guys? Man, this video has eluded me for so long because I've actually made this video twice and I've said no. I'm still not happy with that. This is going to be. What did I say? Well, I said what's up? What's up, guys? Yeah, I said that. Yeah, of course I said that. Damn. We're gonna do a Rickshasa review today. And I did this video twice, and the first time I did it, I'm like, you know what? No, I'm not giving her enough credit. And then the second time I did it, I'm like, no, I'm still not giving her enough credit. So the third time is the charm, right? Third time's the charm. Okay, let's start out with, the Fire Rakshasa. Where is she? Hold on, I can't find her. Oh, no more video, I can't find her. Where the fuck? Oh, there she is. How can I never find these ladies? Okay, so Fire Rakshasa, the Hua, is probably, of the three elements, she's probably my favorite. And she's actually used, this is the only one that's really used quite a bit. I can see why the Wind one has value, though. Well, I can see why they all have kind of value in certain situations. Okay, we have the, she's an attack monster, normally. Well, not normally. She's an attack monster. She has her first skill, Swing. Attacks the enemy with a whip. A cool whip, decreasing the enemy's attack speed for 2 turns with a 50% chance. The damage increases according to attack speed. Okay. Interesting. 50% chance is okay. Attack speed decrease. How could this be beneficial? Well, right now we're seeing that this is beneficial for things like dungeons. Especially Giant's Dungeon. Burning Swing attacks with a burning whip and inflicts continuous damage for 3 turns. Now we're seeing more dungeon benefits. And we're talking like against the pillars and against the bosses, like the dragon and the giant and stuff like that. Then we have the passive, decreases the enemy's attack bar by 25% and strikes again with a 20% chance. Nice that it's a decreasing the enemy's attack bar by 25% is also good for dungeons. And then strikes again with a 20% chance. So how do we see this little lady ruined? Let's check it out. What the fuck did I do? I still want to dance to this. So she's normally ruined either Violent Focus with speed, attack, and accuracy to do those debuffs and those to do those debuffs and then to do those dots. And then the Violent, you know, you just keep getting more chances to attack, which also couples with her her passive skill of striking again with a 20% chance. So you have a much higher chance of striking again. And you really want to capitalize on the Burning Swing. Try to get, you know, decrease their attack bar and keep hitting them with those dots. And this is really, really good for the bosses, the Giant's Keep and the Dragon Slayer. So I find this less useful in Arena, though. And I faced so many of these, and they have never really been any threat whatsoever. And that's why. So plus, I guess you could also say that, well, two of my monsters that I usually use in Arena are wind monsters, so I do have the advantage over her with that. But even without that, I think she's like really, really dungeons. Really good for dungeons. Not so much for Arena. But I understand that some people just have her up at 6-star, and that's why they put her in Arena, because they're like, well, I only have a certain amount of 6-stars, and I'm not going to go and put a 5-star in the Arena, because then it'll be way less powerful. So I understand that. Then we have another rune combination, Swift Focus with Speed Attack. I mean, you could basically just speed on the first one, and then either violent focus or swift focus, or violent and a different two set, or swift and a different two set. If you don't want to use violent, you can just use accuracy on the 6 slot. I mean, not. Never mind. If you don't want to use focus, you can use accuracy on the swift slot, because that's going to give you more of a benefit. If you have a really, really good accuracy rune, you have good accuracy substats, you really don't need to use that those focus runes. So you can fill those that other two set up with something, like if you want to use... what else? I mean, you could use energy, you could use a blade even. So it just depends on what you have. But if you don't have, if you don't want to use accuracy in the two slot, in the six slot, sorry, then you can just get good accuracy substats and you can use two focus runes. I mean, the accuracy can only go up to 100, so you don't really need it to go any higher than that. If you have accuracy on six and you have accuracy substats and two focus runes, you do have the chance of going over the max and then just getting no benefit out of that. So, yeah, but anyway, I think she's the best Rakshasa of the normal elements. Then what do we have here? We have the... Hold on. The Wind Rakshasa. So she's got the same first skill. Damage decreases according to attack speed. Which is one of the benefits of ruining her swift instead of violent. So you can take that into consideration also. We have the fast swing. And we have the dancing whip. Get an extra turn with 15% chance when your turn's out. Actually, that's different than the, that's different than this one. This one is decreases the enemy's attack bar and strikes again with a 20% chance. Yeah. That's why she's not as good as the fire. The fire has a much better third skill. Much better third skill. And that's why you see her use so much. Really good for dungeons, though. And I've been playing with my myself. No, I've been playing with my my wind hooker, my wind rakshasa. And she's not awakened, she's not 6-star, but I feel that I'm still trying to unlock her potential. I see a much higher potential with the fire one, especially for dungeons. Now the water one, Sue. Before I started playing, I guess there was a water rakshasa dungeon, so this girl was pretty easy to get. Some of you may have started playing before I did, but I know some of you were even in the beta and stuff like that. Now we have the swing. Same thing, of course. We have the fast swing, of course, the same thing. Oh no, actually it's not the same thing. Is it? No, it's the fast swing, 3 times in a row, continuous damage for 2 turns if you land a critical hit. That's not the same thing as this one. That's not the same thing as this one. Yeah, completely different skill. I actually like that skill. Of course, these are, she could potentially land a whole bunch of dots. That's the thing. So she's pretty powerful in that aspect. Definitely want to rune her with as high crit rate as possible, as humanly possible. Oh yeah, I'm sorry guys. How's that? Is that better? Inflicts continuous damage for 2 turns if you land a critical hit. Yeah, I mean, you can get so many dots with that skill. That's all I'm going to say. Delicate Whip. Attacks and recovers by 50% of the inflicted damage. Stuns the enemy for 1 turn. If you attack, the enemy is suffering more than 3 harmful effects. This doesn't work on the dungeons, but it is nice. So, man, I really like that fast swing, though. I like that fast swing more than I like the other ones. Just so much more potential to get so many more dots. But of course, you don't reduce their attack age with the passive. That's the only downside. These girls are really good for dungeons. But depending on which dungeon you're facing, these are really more dungeon monsters than arena monsters. These are not like these are like dungeon boss monsters. Like they do really well against dungeon bosses. Not necessarily to get up to the rest of the dungeon. But against the bosses, and they're not good for the secret dungeons of special characters. Like, you know, I mean, you can potentially attack again sometimes, but But no, no AoEs. So we have Swing, of course. We know what that is. We have Burning Swing. We know what that is from the Fire one. Same thing. And then Cruel Whip. He elongates the harmful effect on the enemy for one turn. Damage is increased by 30% if the enemy's HP is below 50. It does combo with the Burning Whip, but I don't think it's that great. I like the Fire one, of course. Of course I like the Fire one. And them boobs. Mm-hmm. Them boobs. We got the Swing, we got the Fast Swing. Also very nice. The same as the Water one. And the Devil's Whip. Attacks an enemy 4 times, decreasing the attack bar by 20% with a 75% chance for each attack, and stunning the enemy for 1 turn if the enemy's attack bar is depleted. Okay, so we have the really nice dot dealer, and then we have the attacking the enemy 4 times, decreasing the attack bar by 20%. And here's the thing, like, you can't stun and freeze. I mean, yeah, it says stuns the enemy if the attack bar is depleted. You could potentially stun big monsters, like normal monsters, but this is decreasing the attack bar by 20% with a 75% chance each attack. That's 20, 20, 20, 20. And you'll probably get 3 of those at least, so it's probably going to be at least like 60%. Really nice. I would say that I like the Dark Rakshasa the best, definitely. Fire after that, and then water, and then wind, and then light. Plus, dem boobs, son. Anyway, I know you guys were looking forward to this video, and you guys were like, do a Rakshasa video, and I was like, I did 2 of them, and I didn't like either of them. I didn't like I didn't like the videos that I did before. Also, hey, white shirt, when do I ever do this? It's a fucking special occasion. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked it, like, comment, subscribe, and maybe, if you're lucky, I'll wear a white shirt next time, too. And then I'll do some dancing.